Hello and welcome to my feature highlights in August 2025 with SAP Datasphere. Another great month with lots of new features and enhancements in our two releases. So let's check out my top features in August. The first one, transformation flow batches. You can now break down large transformation flow datasets into batches to avoid out-of-memory errors when using the SAP HANA runtime in Datasphere. Defining batches on transformation flows enhances the performance and reliability while ensuring efficient data integration and processing. You find this feature in the Data Integration Monitor as it is part of the runtime settings under the Batches tab. Simply pick a suitable column and define the batch sizes in number of records. You can also define it to use it only for large initial loads or also for initial and delta loads. The second one, there are new sources and targets available in replication flows. You can now use Microsoft OneLake, which was formerly also known as Azure Data Lake Generation 2, and its corresponding connection type to add sources to replication flows and replicate data in CSV format from the source for initial loads. In addition, you can now use the connection type SAP Signavio and replication flows to load data from SAP source systems, such as SAP S/4HANA and others, into SAP Signavio as a target system. So this allows an efficient and scalable data replication into the SAP Signavio solution. Last but not least, there is a very nice new feature in SAP Analytics Cloud, which I think is super useful for many of you. So with the QRC 3 release, you can now transfer a table from an SAC story to Excel and further use it with the Excel add-in. So in Excel, the transferred table is based on the same data source, for example, SAP Datasphere, and has the same navigation state, meaning its dimensions, measures in rows and columns, filters and variables. The idea is to benefit from native Excel integration capabilities on Datasphere data in real time. You can, of course, adjust the report and add custom functions on top of the table and more. So again, all in all, very cool features helping you to use Datasphere way more efficiently. Thanks for joining me this month for my feature highlight overview. And if you liked it, give me a thumbs up down here and keep following me on LinkedIn. Also, don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel to get the latest updates. Take care and see you soon.